Hi, this is the Political Checklist. I'm Christina Bellantoni, political editor here at the PBS NewsHour, and I am joined by correspondent Hari Sreenivasan, who has a big piece that we are excerpting on tonight's NewsHour. Yep. This is a collaboration with Frontline, taking a look at one of the really important and undercovered stories of the presidential campaign, and that's a look at data, sort of what the campaigns know about you, the individual voter, what they know about the people that they need to get out to the polls, and sort of how they're targeting them. So why did you do this piece, and tell us a little bit about what people see tonight?
So right now, Frontline already has a 26-minute film on their website, but we're actually cutting it into two parts for the NewsHour. So one part will run tonight, one part will run tomorrow night. But really, what we thought was really important for folks to know is that unlike in previous election where there was all this consumer data about you, now they're able to take the consumer data and combine it with all of your online browsing behavior.
Consumer data like what you're buying on Amazon?
Exactly. Or, yeah. Did you know, back in the old days, in the 60s and 70s, they turned it into a science. Do you subscribe to Cat Fancy or do you subscribe to Guns and Ammo? What neighborhood do you live?
Both, actually.
Yes,
yeah.
Exactly.
I live in Petworth.
Petworth and Guns and Ammo. So then they would try to figure out the probability of, are you a likely Republican voter or a likely Democrat voter, right? So then, now, we have huge troves of data that all of us are generating all the time. So when you go online to make a purchase, what websites that you choose to consume for news? Was it the NewsHour? Is it the Wall Street Journal? The New York Times? Is it a left-leaning blog? A right-leaning blog? All of that ends up painting a really detailed picture of the type of person you are, at least online. Then they combine that with all the data that they already have about you that's already available publicly and free, or whether you're a registered voter in a particular state, whether you registered with a party, whether you decided to vote in multiple previous elections.
Yeah, well, and one thing that you talked to Sasha Eisenberg earlier this year for his book, The Victory Lab, and he and I actually did a book chat this weekend. We were talking about this data of, you know, I actually early voted over the weekend. So does that mean, does the campaign know about that? Are they going to still try to target me? I mean, I'm a Washington, D.C. voter, so nobody cares about me. But if I were a battleground state voter, you know, what is the data in there? And he was saying it's a really interesting test of the campaigns. How sophisticated are they in having up-to-the-minute information about who's early voting, who isn't, so they're not wasting resources on you? So we'll be excerpting this in two parts.
Right.
Tonight, obviously, Tuesday night as well. What is the most important takeaway from this? I mean, what did you learn in your reporting that, you know, people, should they be afraid of all this data out there?
I personally am a little paranoid and afraid, but I don't think that, it depends on your level of comfort with the amount of information that you generate and you have online. There's a generation or two of folks behind me who don't really seem to care about their online privacy and they live their lives very publicly, and so be it. But for me, the amount and volume of information that I'm generating on a daily basis is just scary. I didn't recognize that that's actually traceable or trackable. Even if it's not personalized to be the individual, even if it's anonymized, as they say, the cookie data that they have on me from my computer is astounding.
Yeah, and this is where, you know, when you're targeting maybe 1 million undecided voters total, I'm sure that number's a lot slimmer with less than 8 days of this election to go. I mean, that's a lot of really micro information
right.
that they can.
So, you know,
use.
Last time what we were talking about in the piece is that Zach Moffitt, the digital director for the Romney side, says that Kerry lost the election by a margin of enough people that would actually just fill the Ohio State University Stadium, 100,000 people. Right. And the Romney campaign estimates that there are 2 million people in Ohio alone that are off the gritters, right? So people who you can't reach in traditional ways. I mean, this could be the digitally decided election.
Well, definitely tune into that tonight. And if you can see behind us in the newsroom, everybody looks a little intense because this is Hurricane Sandy is descending on the Eastern Seaboard right now. Yep. The NewsHour will have lots of updates on that tonight. But also, we are running a live blog where you can follow all of the latest developments and our extensive coverage of that on our website, which you're probably watching to see this. So.
Also, shameless plug, after this broadcast, if you're not sandied out, I should say, if you have power, if you're somewhere else besides the Eastern Seaboard, we're going to do kind of a live interactive where you can watch tomorrow's piece with us and be in kind of a live chat room through OV. So check our website for details.
Yeah. See you soon. Thanks.